doing today? Okay, I'm happy to be with you one more time. Today, we're going to talk about adjectives, okay? Do you know what an adjective is? No? Okay. Adjective is the same thing as a description. Description, okay? Yes, but what do adjectives describe? Si un adjetivo es una descripción, ¿qué describe un adjetivo? They describe nouns. Okay? Adjectives describe nouns. What are nouns? You don't remember? Okay, I know you don't remember. Nouns can be a person or people. Can be animals. You know what? Let's write it in plural. Can be people, can be animals, or can be things. Yes. Nouns can be people, animals, or things. Don't forget this, kids. Please. Try to keep it in your mind. ¿Qué son nouns? Son sustantivos. Son personas, animales, o cosas. Entonces, el adjetivo, ¿qué describe? A las personas, a los animales, o a las cosas. Por ejemplo, una caja. Es una cosa, ¿cierto? ¿Y cómo la describo? Una caja pequeña. Ok. Este es un adjetivo. Una caja azul. Eso es un adjetivo. Una caja bonita. Miren. Saqué tres adjetivos. Los estoy haciendo en español, mis niños, porque quiero que me entiendan bien claro. Ya no me paso a inglés. Pero lo que pasa es que no estamos lejos. Necesitamos que esto quede claro, mis niños, ¿ok? So, now, for those of you who do understand English, adjectives are description. It's a description of a noun. Noun can be people, noun can be animals, noun can be things, ¿ok? So right now, what we have here is a caja, you can say a box, ¿ok? The box can be small, the box can be blue, or the box can be nice. So I got three adjectives for the box. Now I'm going to show you how do we use them in English. Because it's different. The way we use adjectives in Spanish is different. For example, I'm going to say, un carro nuevo. This is the proper way of saying it in Spanish. Carro, mi sustantivo. Okay? El nuevo, mi adjetivo. Now, I'm talking, I'm interested in teaching you in English. In English, it's going to be different. Why do we say this? But it's going to be a, un, right? But the adjective is going to come first. The word new goes before the noun. And then we have the word car, which is the noun. A new car. You see the difference? Here we have the adjective before the noun. Got it, kids? Un carro nuevo, a new car. It's in a different order. Comprende? Okay. Let's erase this. Because you always think in Spanish. Not all of you, but some of you think in Spanish. And then your mind goes, okay, una casa bonita. Oh, a beautiful house. It happens in your mind. So pasa en la mente, muy rápido. Now, some of you, I know that you can think in English. Just things come to your mind in English. Like, for example, a beautiful house, a nice car, new shoes, brown house, big dog, I don't know, whatever you want to say, you just think in English. Eso es una ventaja para muchos, que ya estamos pensando en inglés. Eso no se puede cambiar. Pero lo que podemos hacer es trabajar que la mente haga así, rápido, la traducción en la mente, ¿ok? Entonces, if I want to say, for example, I'm going to write three sentences for you. Tres zapatos sucios. You know what? We're gonna go one by one. Tres zapatos sucios. Algo que es bien importante darnos cuenta es que sucios está en plural. Zapatos está en plural. El sustantivo está en plural y el adjetivo está en plural. En inglés eso no sucede, mis hijos, ¿oyeron? En inglés solamente el sustantivo va a estar en plural, pero el adjetivo siempre va a ir en singular. Es algo muy importante. Entonces, how do we say this in English? Tres, oh yes, three, of course. Three. And then comes the adjective. Sucios, how do we say sucio? Dirty. Dirty. We cannot say this in plural. Now, zapatos, yes. Three dirty shoes. Comprende? Okay, let's go with another one. Very quickly. Cinco naranjas anaranjadas. This is a tricky one, but I want you to do it in your notebook. Puse pausa. Pero después, quiero que la hagan en inglés, ¿ok? Take your time and do it. Finish? Okay. Five. What is it? Which one is the adjective? Naranjas or anaranjadas? Yeah, anaranjadas, of course. Naranjas es el sustantivo. So, how do we say anaranjadas in English? Orange. Right? And the noun in plural. Oranges. Five orange oranges. You see this one? All right, kids. Now, there's another way of using adjectives with the help of the be verb. We're going to involve. Vamos a usar el verbo be para trabajar con adjetivos. And teacher, what is be verb? You don't remember? Oh, yes. Be is ser o estar. And this verb has three different forms. The first one is am. The second one, Samuel Herhurst. Tell me, do you remember which is the other one? I bet you do. Is. Santi Molina, why don't you tell me which one is the other one? Or you, Emma, I know you know. Yes, of course, are. So where do you use sentences using am, is, or are to use adjectives? Vamos a hacer adjetivos con el uso de am, is, y are. En ese caso, sí es igual que en español. Por ejemplo, la casa es nueva. Ok. Now, yo no digo una casa nueva. Digo, la casa es nueva. Y estoy trabajando con un verbo ser. Ok. So I'm going to say, the house. And how do we say es in English? Yes, of course, is. And nueva, new. So you see, this sentence basically follows the same pattern as in Spanish. Esta oración sigue el mismo patrón que en español. La, da, casa, house, es, is, nueva, new. It's the same thing. Whenever we use the be verb. Let's do another example, just to make sure you understand everything. Oh, you know what I love? I love dogs. Ahora sí, los perros son grandes. You see how grandes is in plural right here? Okay. As well as perros, right? Plurales, los perros y plural grandes. But in English, dogs. And how do we say some? Am is for are. Yes, are. Are. And how do we say bigs, right? No, no way, Jose, because the adjective cannot be plural. So we have the dogs are big. So it's easy as that, my little kids. Before I leave, before I say goodbye, let me check something very quick. Give me 1 second, kids. I'm gonna write something else, but I want to check something before I leave. Okay. Yes, that's it. Okay, for example, it's not the same thing to say, un gato amarillo, than to say, el gato es amarillo. All right? Until the next one, kids, God bless you all. Bye-bye.